Hi, I'm Senator Todd Kaminsky. Welcome to the Environmental Conservation Committee of our agenda today on Monday, April 25th. I'd like to welcome Senators Harkin, May, Serrano, Palumbo, and Kavanaugh, and Senator Steck, our ranking members here as well. Good to see everybody. We have a good-sized agenda today, so we're going to get started. Emily, if you could please announce the first bill from Senator Harkin.
S-655 by Senator Harkin, an act to amend the environmental conservation law in relation to creating a program to assist lake associations with water quality improvement.
Would anyone like to comment or question this bill? Is there a second? I see Senator May. Well, I guess we need a first. Does anyone want to move this bill? Senator May wants to move this bill. Senator Serrano wants to second it. All in favor?
Aye.
Everyone's in favor. We are going to move this bill to the Finance Committee. Next, 1185C, that's my extended producer responsibility bill. Emily, can you officially read that out, please?
Yep, that's 1185C by Senator Kaminsky, an act to amend the environmental conservation law in relation to establishing the Extended Producer Responsibility Act.
Any questions or comments on this bill? Yes, start with Senator May, then to Senator Palumbo.
Yeah, thank you. So I really applaud you for your work on EPR. EPR is really important. I'm going to be AWR only because I think we need to get a little more specific about targets for waste reduction and minimum recycling and post-consumer content standards, just because leaving that up to DEC leaves us at the mercy of whoever is the governor. And I just think the legislature should have a little bit more control over that. So that's my only reason, but otherwise I totally support it in concept. Thanks.
Yeah, thanks, Senator May. You know, and welcome, Senator Hinchey. I would just say, Senator May, that, you know, one of the things that we have to take into consideration is the various types of different industries that come with paper and plastic packaging overall. And so putting a broad target with a broad date together, you know, obviously sounds ambitious and like will achieve a lot, which I get, but we're talking about very different things that would be covered in that. And it's very hard for me to say that, let's say, a ragu bottle or a ragu jar and a cereal box or a toothpaste tube or an Amazon package all should be treated the same, have the same specifications, and have the same reduction targets over the same dates. I do think the mechanism is going to force them to companies to have to pay more, producers to have to pay more, the more junk they're putting out there, especially if it's hard to recycle and eco-unfriendly. And I think the market is going to bring that weight to bear on that. And that's what we're hoping it will do. But I think when you go down the rabbit hole of figuring out what target should apply to which industry, it gets very difficult. I will say, however, that, you know, I'm hopeful that we can go into negotiations with the assembly on this, and I'm sure it will move more in that direction. So I hear you, Senator May, and I appreciate that. That Senator Palumbo.
Thank you, Chairman, and good morning. And good morning. I too appreciate the goals of this bill as a co-sponsor as well, and you've done great work in this regard. I just have one question and one area that it seems to be somewhat insignificant language at first glance, but I think it's quite significant in the definitions under recycling. The last line as far as chemical conversion processes as determined by the department to not qualify in the state as recycling, and declaring that I guess this would be advanced recycling is not necessarily recycling, I think would have a huge detrimental effect. And I'm not sure why that language is particularly in there. I wonder if you could help me out and explain that. So why we feel that's necessary. That's my only concern.
Yeah, I don't think that's what it means. Emily will go into it in a second. But I think what it basically says is that some of these definitions are what DEC is going to decide. You know, certainly some things are going to be out of bounds right away, but it's not a prohibition. Emily?
Yeah, so as I'm sure you know, advanced recycling is important for certain types of packaging, like kind of chip bags and things like that. But the process is relatively complex. And the reason why that clause is in there is we feel that it's sufficiently complex that DEC should be the one to determine what should be included and what specific processes within that big, very broad bucket of advanced recycling should be included. So we included that caveat to say, broadly, we don't support waste to fuel processes, but other than that, DEC has the authority to determine otherwise.
Okay, thank you, Emily. I appreciate that. And I guess in similar fashion to Senator May, and Senator May and I agree so infrequently, right, Senator? But seriously, I think I agree that's something that it would be best left to a more clear definition, because I think eliminating advanced recycling or declaring some of those processes as not recycling will create a terrible overlap where once the producers come online, then we'll now have a problem as to what to do with that particular type of waste. And of course, the advanced recycling processes remove glass and metals from it. And then we ultimately have a very significant and very important products that are a result of that process. So I think
you're definitely pushing on a pressure point, which we get. It's not an easy question. Look, there's a senator in our conference who has a bill that would mandate certain types of advanced recycling. And there are people who believe it's all just a Trojan horse to be able to continue to, evade recycling requirements. So we try to be smart about it. We think some things are egregious. Some things need to be studied more. When someone says to me, what do you want me to do with this material? The only way I could do anything with it other than landfill it is to do advanced recycling. I am sympathized with that argument. I think there are some people, though, however, who want to create fuels with it and who don't want to come up with any different ways of being more ecologically friendly with their materials and who don't want to find different ways of building the same thing. We obviously don't want people using virgin plastics and things like that. So we try to kind of thread the needle in this way, studying it more, having the DEC study the very specific differences. There are many of these different chemical processes, and to have to lay on the bill which falls in which side of the line would be difficult. I don't think it's fair for us to say they are all okay. I don't think they're all okay. And I think it's hard for us to say that the opposite. So that's the position we take, but I hear you.
Thank you. And I appreciate that, Senator. And you know what? And I think you might be talking about Senator Mannion's bill, that if we could maybe consider by way of another amendment, maybe incorporating that with this bill to find that happy medium, I would certainly be thrilled to see that. And just based on those wrinkles, I'm going to be AWR. But as I said, I think this is, we're definitely on the right track here. But thank you, Jim.
Thanks, Senator. If there are no other questions or comments, would anyone like to move the bill? Senator Harkin, Senator moves it. Senator Hinchy seconds it. All in favor? Okay, this bill will be moved on to finance. The next bill from Senator Gennaris, please. Dan, you're down on it?
Yes.
Okay, and Senator Palumbo and Mayor AWR.
Thank you.
Got it. Right. Zach, anything else you'd like to add? No? Okay. The Senator Gennaris bill, please.
S-1232 by Senator Gennaris, an act to amend the environmental conservation law in relation to declaring a policy of equal treatment in the development and enforcement of environmental laws, regulations, and policies.
Any questions or comments on this bill? Anyone like to move it? Senator May moves it. I'll second it. Any noes or AWRs? Senator Steck is down. Senator Palumbo, are you up on this? He's up on this. Okay. We will move this bill. Next bill from Senator, from myself, please.
S-2937 by Senator Kaminsky, an act to amend the environmental conservation law in relation to prohibiting the use of fuel oil grade number 4 in any building or facility in the state.
Any questions or comments on this bill? Are there any motions? Motion from Senator Serrano, seconded by Senator Palumbo. All in favor? Are there any noes or AWRs? Senator Steck is down, creating a streak of 3. Okay, we're going to now move on with this bill. On to Senator Ramos's bill, please.
S-3211B by Senator Ramos, an act to amend the environmental conservation law in relation to requiring applicants for major projects located near disadvantaged communities to submit an enhanced public participation plan.
Are there any questions or comments on this bill? Is there a motion? I see a motion from Senator Harkin, seconded by Senator May. Senator May, do you second? There we go. All in favor? Are there any noes or AWRs? Okay, we're all up. The streak is broken. This bill is advanced. We'll now move on to Senator Borrello's bill.
S6314 by Senator Borrello, an act to amend the environmental conservation law in relation to establishing a moratorium on the building or placing of any permanent or semi-permanent wind turbine on bodies of fresh water located within the state or off the coastline.
Okay, now this bill was mandated to be on the agenda through a motion by Senator Borrello, so the committee is considering it. I am recommending a no vote on this particular bill. I perfectly understanding having local concerns be taken into consideration and even overriding the ability of a project to come to fruition in a given area. And it may be that projects in the Great Lakes and others in fresh waters near Senator Borrello's district or some of our upstate districts or around the state may not be appropriate. But I do think it's premature to just cast a moratorium on those projects until they could be studied. It could very well be that having wind projects in freshwater bodies may work. They may not work. They may work on different size and proportion. But I do think in light of our state's goals and what we're trying to achieve in creating a green economy, that just simply banning them outright through this bill would be a mistake. Senator Steck, do you have any comments on this?
I'd like to move the bill and speak on it. That'd be all right, Chairman.
Please.
On behalf of the sponsor. The Great Lakes are the largest source of freshwater drinking in the world. There isn't another major lake that has, or another lake that has a major deployment of wind turbines anywhere else in the world. So this will be a first. It's being talked about right now. It's been clouded in a lot of secrecy. There's not been a lot of transparency. I don't know why it wouldn't be prudent to pause and study something before we greenlight something. At first glance, it seems like offshore wind power is twice as expensive as onshore wind power. But more importantly, 11 million people get their drinking water supply out of Lake Erie. And some of these lakes, I think Lake Ontario or Lake Erie, one or the other, both were deemed dead lakes years ago. And they're not anymore because the sediment has covered over all the toxins that are on the bottoms of these lakes. And if we start drilling to put in foundations for wind turbines, we're going to stir that all up. That is the local concern in Western New York. The public is overwhelmingly concerned and opposed right now. So I think the prudent thing would be for us to take control and the legislature, as Senator May had pointed out in a previous bill, and not leave this in the hands of DEC and a future governor, whoever that might be. And let's make sure that the legislature elected by the public has control over the drinking water and the impacts that something like this may have on 11 million people's drinking water. So I think a moratorium is a safe move right now.
Thank you, Senator Steck. And I'll once again reiterate my position. I'm voting no on this. I think that clearly no project should be done in secrecy and sprung on a community. The procedures that the state has put in place should not allow that. And that's obviously a serious concern. And all the environmental impacts, including sediment and quality of drinking water, need to be studied. But I'm not in a position right now to say that I know the answers to all of that and that any ability to create renewable energy in the lake should be banned from this moment forward and perhaps never done at all. So the motion is before us, moved by Senator Steck. We can consider this an open vote. I am voting a no. I'm urging other members of the committee to do so. Are there any final comments before we take the vote? Okay, I see no other comments. All in favor? Senator Palumbo and Steck, all in the negative?
Nay.
No. Okay.
The streak is won.
Okay, the bill is defeated. I don't know where defeated bills go, but they're not going anywhere, I guess. Okay, next bill from Senator Brook, please.
S7483 by Senator Brook, an act to amend the environmental conservation law and the state law in relation to the redesignation of Squaw Island in Ontario County as Skeno Island.
Any questions or comments? Is there a motion? Yes, Senator May.
Yeah, I just want to comment on this bill. It doesn't mention in the bill language what Skeno means, but in the Haudenosaunee languages, it's a word that means peace and welcome. And it is so much more appropriate as a name for this island. And I applaud Senator Brook for making this change.
Very good. I'm glad to be able to help move the bill. Would you like to move the bill, Senator May?
Absolutely.
Yes. Is there a second? Senator Harkin seconds it. All in favor? Any noes or without recs? Okay, I see none. We're moving on. Two more bills left. Senator Gorin's bill, please.
S8281A by Senator Gorin, an act to amend environmental conservation law in relation to zero emissions for trains.
Are there any questions or comments on this bill? Is there a motion? As a Long Island Railroad rider, I will move the bill along with Senator Palumbo. All in favor? Any noes or without recs?
Without rec.
Without rec from Senator Steck. That bill will move to finance, and the final bill from Senator Lanza.
S8357 by Senator Lanza, an act to amend Chapter 306 of the laws of 2011, authorizing owners of residential real property in high-risk brush fire areas in the borough of Staten Island to cut and remove reeds from their property in relation to extending the expiration and repeal date thereof for an additional year.
Any questions or comments? Who would like to move this bill, please?
I would.
Senator Steck and Senator May, all in favor?
Aye.
Aye. Any noes or without recs? Okay, we're moving on. I think we'll have another meeting in the near future, perhaps next week, but I'm glad we could all come together for this committee meeting, and I hope everyone has a great day. Take care.
Thank you.
Thanks.